In a Grove by Ryunosuke Akutagawa. Ryunosuke Akutagawa was a Japanese story writer. After university education, he was engaged as a teacher of English literature at Naval Engineering School and then devoted his entire time to writing. He has written over 150 short stories. This story gives different version of a murder by three different people. The variation in the narration led to some confusion, but it is interesting by revealing the different ways in which people look at the same thing. Summary of Inner Grove. The woodcutter's story gives the first detail of the murder. He saw a dead man on the side of the door to Yamashina. He wore a blue kimono. The body lay in a grove of bamboo and cedar. A single sword thrust on the breast had killed him. There was a rope and a comb. The ground shook. There was a fight before the killing. The traveling Buddhist had seen a man and a wife going from Sekiyama to Yamashina. The man was walking and the woman was on horseback. She had a scarf covering her face. He could not see her. The man was armed with a sword and bow and arrows. There were 20 odd arrows in the skewer. The policeman had arrested the robber, Tajomaru. He must be the murderer because he carried the sword and the bow and arrows of the dead man. The fate of the woman is unknown. Tajomaru is known to have killed other women also. The old woman said that her son-in-law was of gentle disposition and did not provoke anyone. Her daughter was spirited and fun-loving. She had a small, oval, dark mole on the corner of her left eye. The boy was killed by the robber. What happened to the girl is unknown. Tajomaru confessed that he had killed the man and violated his wife. He was attracted by her beauty and wanted to enjoy her. He tempted them with the promise of some treasure he had hidden in a grove in the mountain, and they followed him. The wife stood at some distance. Tajomaru struck the man down and tied him to a cedar with a rope. He gagged him with bamboo leaves. Then he brought the woman there and violated her in the presence of her husband. He persuaded her to marry him. She told him that either he or her husband must die. He decided to kill them. He untied the man and allowed him to fight. He was a good fighter, yet he fell at the 23rd stroke. Then he turned to her, but she had gone. He took up the man's sword and bow and arrows and moved away. The woman told that after violating her, the robber laughed. Her husband could not bear it. His cold look made her fall unconscious. When she woke up, the man had gone. She told her husband they must kill one another. He agreed. She thrust the small sword into his breast. She tried to kill herself with the sword, but she could not. Then she tried to drown herself. That also failed. The medium told the story with some difference. After violating the woman, the robber asked her to become his wife. She said that she can live with him only if he kills her husband. The robber asked her husband what he would do. He told him to kill him. Before he got time to do it, with the woman ran into the depth of the forest. The robber ran after her, but before that he had cut one of the ropes. Now he was free. The small sword of his wife was lying there. He took it up and thrust into his breast. He lay half dead. Someone came in the night and drew the sword out, and he died.